Welcome back to Model Mania 2021, and here we are going to model or exercise or make a simple exercise in SolidWorks, and we will learn basic features like extruded boss base, extruded cut, how to use hole wizard features and create counter bore hole, how to make tabbed hole, how to apply cosmetic thread here. So let's make this simple model in SolidWorks. This is the Model Mania 2021, and we are going to model this simple exercise. Now, this is the top view, you will see. And if you see side view, thickness 20 millimeter. Okay. Now, let's check the dimension. Center to center 80 millimeter, 40 millimeter is the half distance, you will see here also. And center, there is a two circles. 60 millimeter and 50 millimeter. If you see side view, this height 60 millimeter. Even if you are going to check in section view, see here. So let's make this, and at bottom, see, this is bottom view. Wall thickness 5 millimeter typical. That means we are going to use shell feature to create this one, even though we have a drawing here. See bottom. So first we have to choose any plane. So I'm going to start with top plane sketch. Now activate circle tool. Now first we will draw two circles. The first one 50, enter. Again click on center, drag 60, enter. Okay, right click, and you want again circle, so just simply put right, and whatever thing you like you can do it. So let's again, I'm going to make this one. The outer radius, it's 12, so 12 into 2, it's 24, and the inside one, it's 14 radius. Okay, activate line tool, connect from this point to this point, escape or exit. Click this line, convert construction geometry. Activate smart dimension tool. This dimension 40 millimeter, the similar horizontal length 40 millimeter. Okay. Now, let me add some 3-point tangent. Add something like this. Click, select these two and make relation tangent. It helps us. Okay, now click, select this things, and here click circular sketch pattern. Now you will see the preview. It's already going to make four number of instances. See here, 360 degree equal spacing, and this all are selected by default. So say yes, but there is a problem. You will see here, this point is not defined. So I'm going to put somewhere here. Then again, I am going to select both the arc, tangent relation. Okay, this is something near to defined edge. Activate smart dimension tool, and this one. 75 millimeter. You will see, this is fully defined sketch. Now exit and go to features and activate extruded boss base tool, because we want to extrude. Now here more than one geometry, so you have to choose all the closed geometry one by one. Let's say this one, this one, this one. Okay, now here we will keep end condition blind, direction we will make upside, and depth or thickness 20 millimeter. Say yes. Look, now backside there is a shell. So I'm going to use shell tool. Now here put thickness 5 millimeter and click show preview. Select this one. You will see. Say okay. Look. Again, drop down the first extruded boss base menu. Select sketch, extrude. Again, we have to choose here which things we are going to extrude. So I'm going to choose this one. Okay. Now extrude up to 60 millimeter. Look. Say okay. But here we did some mistakes. So edit feature, and here we forget to add this section also. Say okay. Now that's perfect. Now let's check here. You will see the all red fillet 3 millimeter. Here also the same thing. So if you check in drawing, let's make this one first, then we will add radius. You will see here cross section view 12 millimeter, 30 degree angle, and center distance from center line 36 millimeter, and from bottom edge 42 millimeter, and you will see the width 36 millimeter. Okay, so we will extrude this one first. Front plane, this is suitable. Sketch, activate line tool. Now go back to the point and see it automatically convert into arc. Okay, now I am going to connect this point to center point. Construction line, make sure it is horizontal. Hidden line visible. Now I am going to hide, fix up to this line. This is important, otherwise it moves outward. Okay, that's smart dimension. Radius 12 millimeter, the center distance 36. Now the distance from bottom 42 millimeter, and the angle 30 degree. See, this is fully defined sketch. Now activate extruded boss base feature. See, it moves in one direction. So keep direction and condition mid plane, and here depth 36. Say yes. But see, there is a gap. So how to fill this one? In this is both side. So if you go to direct editing, you will find option delete face. If I am going to choose one face, it gives you, see, too many options. So this one, all coplanar face one, I'll choose this one. See, I'll show you, it automatically select other side. No need to select one by one both faces. Delete and patch. Say yes. Look, it's patch. Okay, let's check fillet. Inside there is a fillet, the corner have fillet, this also fillet, and this one also fillet. Okay, then there is one cutout. So you will see here 3 millimeter saw cut at the center. So we will add this also. So fillet, I'll choose if this face 3 millimeter. Look, it took all the features. This corner, and choose this edge, and select bottom face. But there is a corner also, you will see here. If I'm going to say okay, and I'm click one corner, it gives you option. So the first option is better. Choose first one and see, it will automatically select all the inside corners. This is the constant size fillet. Say yes. Look, now click on the fillet, and here drop down, and you will see here fillet. Click, and let's change the color. Say okay. Look, we apply color on all the fillets. You will see inside also. Top face. Activate line tool and draw one line from this corner to up to this face. Now no need to draw any dimension. Click extruded cut. Here keep end condition through all. Uncheck dimension to direction to thin feature and here choose mid plane. See, it's going to move in both side. Thickness 3 millimeter. Look, say yes. Look how we cut this one. Now let's see the last feature. There is a counter bore hole. See counter bore for NC metric M8 socket hit cap screw, and this hole throughout 9 millimeter, 15 the counter bore diameter and depth of counter bore 8 millimeter. So if we choose directly this one, no need to define this one. Then this one is up to here, and the half of this there is a tabbed hole M8. See, this is tabbed hole 7 millimeter diameter. So let's check hole wizard, and here one option called counter bore. See metric, and here I am going to choose socket head cap screw M8. This is the thing normal, and up to next position I'll choose this face. Once you choose this face, it will show you where going to put. So just keep cursor near and you will see center point. Okay, even though you can define this point from here to this point should be 36. See, say okay. Look, hole wizard. Now this time tabbed hole, so there is a straight tab. Metric, bottoming tabbed hole M8, that's it. Next, and here choose with thread call out. Yes, position, select inside face and move cursor, and you will fix point here. Escape key, say okay. Option, documents property, detailing, shaded cosmetic thread, say okay. Now you see, you will see thread. Right click, material, edit material, or simply choose plain carbon steel. Look, but we will give appearance something different. So I am going to choose here brass, brushed, this is seems better, even though you can change the color of brass like yellow. Okay, now look, this seems more realistic. So this is the simple exercise or simple model in SolidWorks. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.